Hello, Ark. Are you watching me record, Ark? We're here to talk about two things. Well, a couple things. Mayflower Ark, just released, just announced. Everyone's happy. I'm also going to talk a little bit briefly about the Mod Mic 5 because I've been using it on my streams and everyone loves it, but I never actually talked about it. Future of you may come fully on it, but I really want to get that out there. Let me pause Glitch Mob, and by the way, because people who are going to ask, well, actually, let me not pause Glitch Mob yet, because I'm going to unplug this, and the RCAs are going to send Glitch Mob to the Mackies. Not controllable here. Okay, so, what is an ARC, and why do I care? Didn't Noah put animals on it? Is there animals on this Zeos? Are there little tiny animals living in it? Yes. The ARC is high-end technologies with product specs and about this product. With it, actually, the ARC has a 10-year warranty, which isn't bad for any... 10-year warranty, okay. Let's discuss why it's special. And not the little tiny school bus special, like the real type of special. DSP button, which I will explain to you right now, is like a bass boost, but on crack and speed and ether, raw ether, because it gives you like, let me boil this down. This is the gamer's DAC amp. You don't have to play games, but mostly gamers are going to buy this. There are other options if you don't game, anything else. Literally anything else. The reason this is the gamer's DAC amp is because right there, it's got a microphone input. And that's not only rare, that's impossibly rare. I found one other unit sitting on the table behind me that has a headphone out and a microphone. Real quick, why that's important. Mod mic doesn't matter. Vmota Boom Pro matters. The Neo Musica that works with the Sennheisers matters, because the four poles that go into the splitters, and the, here's one of the splitters, goes from a four pole, and it separates out your mic and headphones, and they share a ground. And when you plug the headphones into your $50,000 headphone amp, which obviously you're using, and then you run an extension to run this to the back of your computer, you get this noise. And I can't hear you guys, because the grounds are not, that you've moved them too far apart. They're trying to share ground because of a four pole wire and they can't. So there's only one solution to that. One, other than getting a ground loop isolator and putting it before your headphones, which will ruin the sound a little bit and your volume, is to just unplug your $50,000 amp DAC and just plug into your onboard, because your onboard has a microphone and a headphone out, and they're right next to each other, and they share the ground, and it's perfect. So the fact that this high-end and legitimate quality here, people, like I don't have to make up any lies about how it sounds. T50s just came off my head. Hard to drive. You can tell when shit's fucked. Shit is not fucked. So we plug that in. We plug this in. Then I don't have the Vmota adapter. I only have the Neo Musica adapter, but that seems fine. It's the same, it does the same job. Plug in. We now have high-end microphone. And it is a microphone. The way the microphone, it has to be amplified and put in. And Weird Al's playing. Hold on. UHF. My only major like dislike so far is that I have to unplug the headphone to hear Weird Al. I like things with push buttons, and there's plenty of space right there so that I could just push a button and have it switch to the RCAs. We should look at the back of the unit. By the way, RBH HP2s, which... this works. Putting you down. Let's show off these. These. Which side are we on? The right side, which means this goes that way. Back of the unit. Back to the back of the unit. Left and right RCA outputs. Line outs. only work when you unplug. It's unfortunate. But same quality as a DAC internals. Here's your switch for USB or optical. Currently using optical, which when you're using a, you could use this on a game console and you could use optical. Or if you don't want to deal with USB, because there are some issues where it's 24-bit, 96, or 48, and that's it, and Wasapi, then you could use optical. That is a microphone output. Again, when you're using optical, if you want to use the microphone input, boom, you get a 3.5mm output, plug it in like normal. Full-size USB, high-low gain, which I do not need for these, your optical input, which is a regular full-size optical, and a 5-volt DC 2-amp, which seems to provide plenty of power for pushing like T50s. Now, I say plenty of power, still not A100 power, because obviously that's the same price as this, but just a massive amp with toroidal transformers. So feeding this optical from the laptop, and I say from the laptop, but I actually mean from this Mica Origin Gen 2, because it's there, and it's the only thing that gives me an optical out. So, it works. I have microphone recording capabilities. Wonderful full range microphone recording capabilities. Well controlled sound. Now the volume knob in this is not analog. It's not like that knob or that knob or that knob where it's a pot that actually controls voltage. It is a fully digital knob. It doesn't feel digital, it just feels like a normal knob, but there's a slight delay. And in fact, if I turn the knob really fast left and right, the volume doesn't change because it doesn't know what I'm doing. It's a rotary encoder without the clicks, I guess. So what that means is you never get that, you know when you play really quiet, you turn anything up really quiet, you get that imbalance because it's an imperfect system, it's physical. And the right channel will be loud and then the left channel will come up and there'll be a slight difference, maybe. Doesn't have it, digital volume knob. It also means you almost can't distort this because it's not, you're not raising like voltage and it's just gonna happen. You could turn this up to maximum and the DSP inside of it is smart enough to just calm things down. And if I was gonna hear distortion, it would have been on the T50s, which it did not distort. The microphone input's important. Having a headset, and I don't have a game, I have one gaming headset behind me, it's the Astro A40s, and I will eventually look at it. But fuck all gaming headsets, Zeos 2017. So we've made a couple of our own. We've got RBH HP2s, bass, the DSP I was describing as just crack and heroin and whatever other legal substances I was talking about. They kick up the low end. It kicks up the low end, that's the first thing you'll notice. And then you'll notice that sort of like bigness that's added. Almost unusable on these because these are already insane headphones, which will obviously get their own review. These, however, and the ships are not bass monsters. No one has ever said the ships are bass monsters. So on the ships, I could use the V-Moto Boom Pro because it has a 3.5mm, but I use these for my streaming on Twitch. When I Twitch stream, I use the V-Moto, I use the Mod Mic 5, which sounds wonderful. Look at the little connection, it comes off. It goes down two wires. If I want to plug it into this, which again, it's gonna switch. Wow, it's doing a thing. I wonder what's recording now. Echoes there. Echoes there. Settles down. Ships, come on. People want me to review cheap stuff that sounds great. Nothing will beat the ships under 100 open. Nothing that I found. I've got a bunch that'll compete closed. The closed game is not won yet, but the ships have won the open game. And I'm talking on this microphone, this Mod Mic 5. No, actually it reverted to its primary sound driver. Can I switch? Audacity is just not happy with unplugging and plugging mics, so you'll have to excuse that little aspect of this review. I haven't figured out a way to make it not be a bitch. Stop. Why did it record immediately? Come on. Sound. Recording. Microphone array. Oh! Stop, I'm dumb. I'm using the Spitiff. I have to not use the Spitiff. Now the Spitiff has disappeared. Now that's playing. Now we're gonna flip the switch to USB. Plug in USB, which is the way you're probably gonna wire this up. And now this is working again. That fast. Windows 10 is that. Windows 7 was having an issue. I was having an issue with this on Windows 7. It was a little bit stuttery. Like every minute or so, we're just like, nothing on Windows 10. So now the microphone array, let me record on this now. Mute the record. Oh God, close this. Everything's playing and stop playing and oh my God, my brain. Primary sound recording, go. Go. There you go. This music is tripping me out. Hold on, let me see what it is so I can tell you so you don't ask. Chemical Brothers, the state we're in. Official. Put on the DSP correction because I want a little more low end. I said a little more low end, did it? On low bass cans, like the ships, appreciated. And actually, these are pretty much low soundstage. It's very accurate imaging, but low soundstage, so. Doesn't hurt gaming. That's a gaming button. This is a gaming unit for people who want to game with a microphone, because that's why you'd add this, unless you want to really be on Skype a lot. But, oof. And for some reason, in is off and out is on, so. I didn't design it. Where was I? I honestly forgot. Quality amplification. T50s, no problem. Digital volume knob, no clipping, no problem. The microphone input actually is clearer than most microphone inputs on like laptops. When I go to do a shootout for these three microphones, which will be the Vmota Boom Pro will come back to represent. I've got this Neo Musica, which fits Sennheiser and Audio-Technica. So it's basically a Vmota clone, except specifically for these and Audio-Technica, which actually might be a bigger range of headphones than the Boom Pro can handle. And then the Mod Mic 5. The fantastic Mod Mic 5 with a switch here for omnidirectional or unidirectional. I always leave it on omnidirectional because it makes me sound thin. It just blocks out rear stuff, but it makes me sound thin. What haven't I plugged in yet? Let's plug you in. You need an adapter, which is on the end of this. Wish the floor wasn't so low. I could just get this stuff done real fast. And nothing sticks to my pants. It's just, do you hate that? Do you hate when nothing sticks to your pants? Ladies? This is gonna take an hour to untangle this disaster, but I want this review out. Actually, this review is skipping the Patreon. I apologize to my patrons, because they're supposed to get it, but Mayflower's like, look, can you get this out Friday? And I'm like, sure thing, no problem, boss. Well, it's Friday, right now. This review is coming out an hour and a half after I'm done with it. Just because I postponed and then I had to get the clips picked up today. Things. Don't have to explain myself to you. I'm an adult, damn it. I'm the king. Any man who has to call himself the king, keep reminding everyone that he's the king is no king. So, let's stop talking about how I'm the king and play some goddamn tracks. So it's in, the mode switch is off when it's not on, and when you pull this out, it's blue when it is on. I wish it was more than one mode. It would be kind of cool if I could switch through DSPs. I like how the power LED, by the way, is white. Just because it's not blue. And if you leave that off, then you get no blue. By the way, green. Just gonna point out that that's green and I love it. High-low gain switch, USB optical mic output switch. The mic out's a sort of a thing. I can't test it on my laptop because my laptop has no microphone input. It's super weird. The Lenovo here just has 3.5 millimeter and single. That's it. Here's your alternative to this for gaming. ModMic gives you it. Here it is. This is a sound card. I've seen similar sound cards for like $7 on Amazon, and I just laugh and then don't buy them. This is what has to be done. If you don't want to use your onboard sound and you try to use a better jack amp, because none of these have microphone inputs. The whole point of this ARC is the microphone input. And once you get past that and you get to the DSP, soundstage, bass increaser, you get to the perfect volume knob because it's digital. You get to the fact that it has line outs. I like line outs more than pre outs. This has pre outs. Great for powered monitors. You plug them in with a 3.5 millimeter and you could adjust your speakers fine. You don't have powered monitors, you've just got an amp. This straight to your amp, then you adjust normal passive speakers. Great. I don't like the fact you have to unplug it. I don't like having to unplug something to make other things happen, because, you know, how many times can you do this before it stops? It's just there. Oh, Jesus, look what I've done. Just in and you stay there forever. I'm sure that'll be gift. Someone will rip that out. I did it on purpose. It's not funny if I did it on purpose. Anyway, let's talk a little bit about the ModMic 5, because it will have a review in the future. I just want to talk about it a little bit now. Because honestly, this can go straight into your sound card and you can get your headphones and $10,000 amp deck because it's not sharing a ground because it's a completely separate unit. But they still include a sound card. They include this thing, which is a combiner into a four pole. So you could guess you could use it on your phone, or I guess like an Xbox controller has the plug, the single plug in the thing, and you need one of those. Oh, that's bulky as hell. Here's a little mutey. It mutes, it's not muted, and now it's muted. So that's just a cutoff between a 3.5 millimeter female and male. Little clips, a short extension, 3.5 millimeter extension, because you need it for this. This currently has on it the long 3.5 millimeter extension. And it comes with two of these little magnetic bases. They have double stick tape on, you stick them to whatever headphones. I had a choice when I was gonna test this. It was gonna be either, well, actually, it wasn't ever going to be these. It was going to be the K712s, because I love those for gaming. Or, I'm not shitting you, my Etherflow Cs, or Ether C Flows, however you want to call them. And I just couldn't, I tried to stick it to it, and I just went like this, and my hand froze, because I can't stick something to like $1,800 headphones. I just kept missing. So, but it's nice, though, because they give you a second one. So I could pop this off, because it's just a magnet. Put this on anything else and then pop it on that. You go back on here. There'll be a sound quality test sometime in the future. It's not tonight. This is not the night for it. That's paused. Unpause that. What the world needs now is love. Sweet love. This is by Jackie DeShannon. These reviews are coming. Everything's coming. I'm coming. Everything's coming. I'm coming, phone. Wow, those are efficient. How much louder it got? This is like a benchmark DAC. But I know it's not literally a benchmark DAC. Those things are like $2,000. But the cleanliness of it, I'm talking about the features and how it's got a, it's got an amp, it's got a microphone. Why does that matter? It was $250 CO, so why does it matter? Did I mention the 10-year warranty? I think I did at the beginning. I can't remember. I've done this review like three times now. It's love, sweet love. Here we go. You see, these RBH HP2s with beryllium drivers, by the way, beryllium, are bassy. So when you put that DSP on, you want to puke. So if you have lightweight cans, and by lightweight I mean like lightweight and bass, like both of these, all day, you may want to be cautious throwing that on with heavy bass cans. It will not work. It will work. It'll just be like, oh, gaming is probably fine. Music is a no-no. So, oh, we should also get to the fact that this is a 24-bit only 48 and 96K only USB DAC. So if you was, if you're, okay, I game Zeos, but I also am an audiophile asshole. And I use Wasapi, only Wasapi, because Wasapi will bypass Windows and talk directly to the sound device. And it'll say, this file is 44.1 16-bit. Play it. And this, through USB, will go, no. And it'll just error. So what I had to do to get around that is, at least in FUBAR, if you're using normal, you know, Redbook CDs, which are 16-bit 44.1, you have to go and you have to add a DSP to resample up either to 48 or to 96. And then, because you could set it to 24-bit and that's fine, everything can use 24. Games don't care, Skype won't care, Spotify won't care, Tidal won't care. What's another stupid app people play? Peggle. People still play Peggle, right? Peggle won't care. But specifically, if you have a music player that you have Wasapi or ASIO in, and you don't set it to upscale, it just won't work. The way around that is either add upsampling to from 44.1 to 48 or to 96. I would go right to 48 just because less processing power. Or use the fiber optic input. Because when I turn this on, that takes over as the default DAC. I flip that switch. So this isn't really acting as a DAC. All this is doing is making SPDIF come out of it. This laptop now making SPDIF go. Let's see, let's double check. So now when I go library, configure, output, instead of being on direct sound, I can pick Wasapi 24-bit to the origin, which is just whatever the sound card would be. And it's Wasapi-ing out to this, and it's sending to this. See, USB, I said this, I'm gonna say it again. It's playing, look, it's playing. Wasapi's playing to this, clear as a bell. No interference, Windows can't make sounds. USB is dying as a form of transmitting audio. It's been the staple. Everyone plugs their USB sound card in, USB DAC amp, USB. USB, USB. If you haven't noticed, and I've noticed because I live in this fucking world, things are backing away. That Gashelli Labs DAC that I have in my living room now, that has replaced the ODAC for my speaker listening, there's no USB on that. And I talked to the couple who made it, and they're like, it's too hard to get it to work on every system, and then you need to do publishing rights, and you need to fucking make sure. Where fiber optic just works. And I've seen a lot of modern equipment. Oh, everything needs to be 384 DSD and 32-bit float point integer. No, it doesn't. 24.96 or 192 is plenty. And people are starting to realize that. It's also, if you don't have to register a USB port, you don't have to design it, you don't have to worry about drivers, you don't have to worry about a download. We're all going to be moving to SPDIF soon. So as long as your computer has SPDIF or you can get SPDIF, a Behringer UCA202 is the cheapest option, I think, to just plug in something USB and give you a fiber optic output. It's like $21, $28. I haven't looked up a Behringer UCA202 in a while. But once you go SPDIF, now there's no problems. Now there's no drivers. Now this computer doesn't even know this exists. However, the microphone's not working. The microphone's not in the list. You need the USB to make the microphone work, but if you want to play music, you gotta go SPDIF and then you'll have no problems. So you have to choose the form of the destructor. Most of you are just gonna get this plug-in USB, it's gonna load instantly, it's gonna play fine, and you're gonna have no problems. If you're someone who's considering like Wasapi and you gotta do it, then just do the thing. And if you've got game consoles or even wanna, you can't really see putting this in a living room. I mean, you could. In a very, very lonely world where you have a beautiful living room that you live alone in, like mine, I could have fiber optic hook up to a Blu-ray player or a game console, which is the same thing. I could have the USB hooked up to a gaming computer, which obviously you'd have because consoles suck. PC Master Race. I'm not a dick in the PC Master Race, but I am a legit member. And then you could put this output to an amp, and then you could plug your headphones in, and you could sit, and you got perfect audio. And it's really, really, really clean. No, they're not charging. They're charging $250 for this. They don't have to, but they're putting like ODAC levels of DAC in this. That's another. Oh, it's got a microphone input. Why? Because it's like an ODAC quality. It's like the JDS says OL. Like it's up. It's up there. It's one of those DACs that's as high as DACs need to get, because Zio said so. So keep that in mind. By the way, look at these three gaming headsets. I will link to everything here. If you want to make gaming headsets out of this and a Vmota Boom Pro, this and a Vmota Boom Pro, this and the Neo Musica, or take the Mod Mic 5 and stick it to your anything you want. I also considered sticking it to my Stax L700s, but I just don't have the heart. Bastards. Plus, I have a desktop mic. See, desktop mic? That makes everything we're talking about useless. Just desktop mic and a small little thing and XLRs and move on. But for people who need that headset, you need that microphone right in your mouth because you're in a dog kennel and dogs are barking. This is what's going to get you through. Look how many things it's got plugged into it. I have one thing not plugged in, the mic input, or the mic output, which will just pass through. That's another option, by the way, because then it covers your ground loop because you're going in doing and then covers it. It's all covered. Any questions about this, please ask them in the comments, and hopefully someone other than myself will answer them, because I'm gonna pass out of my bathroom for about an hour. Wallpaper, very, very judging wallpaper in the description. And I think I've mentioned all the music I was playing. It didn't play much. All these headset, I have to do a refreshed gaming. I think it's two and a half years old when I talked about gaming headphones. And this is basically like the setup for the next one. It's like, well, look, you can get this or this or this, and all of them gonna fuck gaming headsets. Or that. Or those. There's so many things you can get that are not gaming headsets. Just shit on gaming headsets. And this is gonna help. This is gonna help. If I still have it around when I'm doing the gaming redo, this is coming out and getting talked about. Because it helps. There's so many gamers. If all the gamers in the world became just partial audiophiles, and I don't think of audiophiles as those assholes who play sit in chairs and Maxell commercials. Just people who care about how things sound, they won't be able to sell crappy headsets anymore. And then where will the world be? The whole world will be like on vacation. It'd be amazing. So yeah, links to the Mayflower, links to all this. A big thank you to everyone who sent me anything ever, because I can't remember anymore, including the Mod Mic 5, which gets the most use of any microphone in this apartment, because when I stream for 13 hours, it's all you hear me through. And check out the Patreon in the upper right. There's a link to the Twitch in the description. There's also a link to the Patreon down there and anything else. And are we done? Good. I'm hungry. I'm going to go make dinner. Later.